History tells us that for thousands of years, our ancestors were also users of various drugs. But this is not so surprising as the fact that apparently we are not the only users in this world. We assume you've read the news regarding the kangaroos that got high after eating poppy flowers. Or you've seen the hilarious video of the wood pigeon in New Zeeland hanging upside down after eating too much fermented fruit. Stoned or tipsy animals, they're internet gold. But as you might expect, most of these cases are made up. In 2013, the internet went nuts over a video showing dolphins apparently getting high by passing around an inflated puffer fish and milking out its toxins. After a few chews, the dolphins drifted motionless at the surface of the water like they were super stoned. Or as one zoologist said, maybe they were somehow fascinated by their own reflection. A puffed pufferfish is basically an underwater beach ball for the dolphins, like our other living things too, like octopuses. There were some dolphins off the coast of New Zeeland that passed around an octopus in the very same way. We think this must have been fun for the dolphins, of course less fun for the octopus. However, it's possible that dolphins were doing their version of puff puff pass, but we don't have any evidence to support this. Tales of drunk elephants date back to 1839, when a naturalist reported that Zulu guides told him they had seen elephants behave strangely and aggressively after eating fruit from the marula tree. The naturalist realized that the fruit of the marula tree had spent lots of time in the ground and was fermented. These stories are told even today, but it turns out they're just ancient tales. There are some arguments that this whole story of the drunk elephant has no scientific basis, and these were addressed in a 2006 study in the journal Physiological and Biochemical Zoology. The main argument of the study was the fact that elephants usually consume fruits ripened on tree branches, not fermented fruits on the ground. But most importantly, the math doesn't add up. Fermented fruits don't have much alcohol. To get drunk, an elephant would have to eat four times than its maximum daily amount, all assuming that the fruit contains about 3% alcohol as usual. So there's no way an elephant can eat enough fruit to get the 27 liters of juice that he would need to get drunk. And to give a more compelling reason why these animals are acting aggressively, this is our conclusion. Elephants can act aggressively because they don't want some weak monkeys to steal their precious fruits from the marula tree. Cows are intelligent, very sociable animals, and are even revered as sacred creatures in some parts of the world. If you've ever seen cows, you may have noticed that they sometimes look a bit lost. This is because they stare at the sky and seem to be shocked by what they're seeing. And you've certainly had the impression that they've consumed something unusual. Chances are they've been consuming loco weed. This is the common name for poisonous plants that produce the chemical swainsonine. When animals consume this seemingly innocent plant, they become less fertile, have miscarriages, malformed babies, or die of heart failure. So why do cows and other livestock animals eat these plants with all these negative effects? Research say that some loco weed tastes very bad. However, if there's nothing else to eat, cows are forced to eat it. And scientists think they get used to the taste over time and can pass that habit on to others. According to another 1994 study, this is not an addiction. It's more of a habit of eat everything you can find and also what everyone else is eating. We believe it's already universally known that cats are crazy for catnip. In 1962, researchers at Harvard described what they call the catnip effect in cats. In this characteristic 10-minute reaction, the cat goes from sniffing and licking to rubbing its face on objects while spinning, all this by being under the influence. Reactions to catnip are similar to the behaviors that all animals naturally do in a sexual context. Likewise, all that rubbing and twisting is how cats tell other cats they are interested in them. Research shows that not all cats, but only 2/3 or 3/4 of cats seem to be interested in catnip because they don't really miss it. So far, scientists have not found any evidence that animals of the wildlife, once exposed to these substances, seek to try them again as humans do. But why do people want and continue to consume? It's complicated. Just thinking about it makes me want to drink a beer. We'll see ya. Head held high.